is fucking fun.
Yeah, so basically, in a nutshell, my hype just severely fucking dwindled for this. Because they gave so many people access. And I'm not even talking just like big mainstream streamers. I'm talking about like some random streamers as well.
I have killed thousands. I have fed more drug fiends than the top three pharmaceutical companies combined. I have stolen children from parents, wives from husbands, wiped out entire generations. But lying, that I have never done. The rest are offenses against humanity. Lying is an offense against yourself. I am the head of the Santa Blanca organization, which you call a cartel. I had a dream. I dreamed
I have a dream.
We could grow our own coca, produce our own cocaine, where we could run our business free from interference from the police, the government, the army, the Yankees. In my dream, a woman's voice asked me,
"Sueño, mijo, what if you had your own country?"
Like Moses, I led my people to the promised land, Bolivia. We came here, we bought the coca fields. What we couldn't buy, we took. We bought the police, the military, the judges, the politicians. We were on the verge of becoming the government itself, on the razor's edge from fulfilling my dream. Of creating a narco state. The nation of Santa Blanca.
Dude, that sculpture at the end literally looked real. What the fuck?
Last week, a crude explosive detonated outside the U.S. Embassy in La Paz, Bolivia. Two Marine Embassy guards were injured in the blast. 2 days later, a CIA asset in central Bolivia provided us with these images. Our analysts have identified the individual in the photo as DEA Special Agent Ricardo Ricky Sandoval, my friend. Sandoval has had spent the last 6 years investigating the local cocaine industry. Our understanding is that Sandoval was the intended target of the bombing. What the embassy bomb did not accomplish was completed up close and personal. Sandoval was captured, tortured, and killed. Then his body was dumped. We have yet to recover it. Our target, the group responsible for the embassy bombing and the death of Special Agent Sandoval, is the drug trafficking organization commonly known as the Santa Blanca Cartel. Yesterday, they were just narcos. Today, they're narco-terrorists. Initially, the Bolivian government resisted the Mexican cartel. They formed UNIDAD, a Bolivian Special Forces unit. It didn't go as planned. Thousands of bodies later, politicians, police officers, and journalists have become an endangered species. The Bolivian government has imploded on itself. With no other options, the new president made a deal with Santa Blanca. You stop killing our people, we'll look the other way. Since then, Santa Blanca has turned Bolivia into the nexus of the South American drug trade. With their friends in Mexico, they also have a clear pipeline to the US and Canada. The only way to stop Santa Blanca for good
Mexico DLC.
Is to completely dismantle them, piece by piece.
Calling it.
The cartel is organized into four operations. Production. Smuggling. Security and influence. At the top of it all is El Jefe de los Jefes, boss of bosses.
El Jefe.
El Sueño.
El Jefe. There's only one. El Jefe.
My name is El Jefe. My name is Jeff.
El Jefe.
Wow, 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 wow. Oh shit, we're making it. My bad, I was like mildly distracted. I I'm gonna just make my character from the beta, but I don't remember what the fuck. I'm gonna try and accurately re-represent my beta character. But I can't remember who I had. Snake. What the fuck? I think I had Mason. I think Mason was the dude.
Mason.
Yeah, it was Mason, I remember.
Mason.
I think I had the, I think I did have the lumberjack. These are basically me represented in this game. More or less. Probably more or less than more. It's basically Walton Goggins from fucking Six. Oh shit. Facial detail. Oh no, this is just like. Hey, the Michael C. Clark. K. Clark. Whatever the fuck. Interesting. Let's just get through this quick because it'll be easier to fucking do. What the fuck? Yeah, if they actually had any decent tattoos, but there's like literally 8 tattoos right now. The hell? Fuck that. Business casual. Yes. Fuck, I forgot that I need I can't remember what camo I use because I go full on OCD when it comes down to camo. Unless there's any like new clothes right now, like is there anything? Oh, there's a lot of shit, but it's all like content locked, great. Damn, look at that shit. Access the store to unlock this item. Oh god. Pay to win, motherfuckers. Pay to win. Let's go with a cry combat shirt, fuck it. I can't remember what the first area is. I could spend forever doing this shit. So these three. I don't know why there's white in there, like it's just weird. I could have sworn there was more colours, but I guess not. Damn! There's way more colors for this. You know, I should probably not spend like a ridiculous amount of time doing this because if I get the color scheme completely fucking wrong, I'm probably just gonna end up changing it, to be honest. Random. Fuck the ghillie suit. Fuck the hat as well, and the fucking eye patch over here. What the fuck is this? Solid Snake. Fucking combat glasses or something. Ballistic goggles. Blacked out. Did I have face? I don't know if I did. I don't think I did. I had a fucking helmet. Where's the helmet? Yes. Automate. Handwear? The fuck? Fingerless ones? There you go. You can't remember? Oh no. Did I have a backpack in there? I think I had this backpack actually. I also don't know if there's any point in how... Oh, you've got to have a bad pack. What the fuck? I must have been. There's like no actual benefit from having a backpack. At all. Wait, what? What? You know what? Because I'm probably just going to change it anyway if the camo is wrong. Because OCD. Why does that not look right? Something looks different. I think it's that. Something looks odd and I can't tell what it is. Like, it doesn't look the same as what my my original camera look like. Huh. Fucking OCD. Fuck it. I'm leaving. I think it's a chin strap. I think that's what it is. Like, I think it's a fucking chin strap. Whatever. You know what? I could do this forever and I can change it down the road. So, yeah, let's go. Extreme! Too extreme! Ooh, yeah! Ooh, yeah! Still really want to play Rainbow Six right now, but god damn it, I told you this game isn't going to replace my Rainbow Six addiction. I might just like begin playing Rainbow Six at the weekend at this stage. Or maybe just alternate between the two, like day to day, I don't know, right now. I just really badly wanted to play Rainbow Six today, but I really badly want to play this as well. And I can only play one game at a time. These are facts. I can only play one game at a time. Ubisoft presents... Ubisoft Paris production.
agent they murdered. You knew him?
He was a friend of mine.
Sorry for your loss.
I could say a job, but it doesn't get any easier.
No, it doesn't.
Emotional bonding.
Guess you've been down here a while.
I've been living as Karen Bowman.
Generating characters.
Just about 5 years.
That you don't give a shit about because this gameplay is 95% gameplay. Well, this game is 95% gameplay.
It comes with a chopper.
Whatever. I fucked it up.
How'd you get in country? I flew in business class from Manaus. Hey, I'm refreshed and ready for work, right? I just hitched rides from Barranco, Peru. How about you?
I got on board a bus in Huy, Argentina, and drank all the way to Villazón. Nobody wants to deal with a drunk on the bus.
That explains why you smell like ass.
I've heard rumors about you guys. I was a rookie field officer in Moscow when the coup went down. There was talk you were involved?
Nah, it must have been someone else. We were never there.
Not every day you get to meet an urban legend in the flesh.
Huh, you should tell that to my kid. Maybe he'd listen when I tell him to take the trash out.
Is it hard being someone who doesn't officially exist?
You tell me, Karen Bowman, international aid worker.
Not gonna lie, the writing's pretty poor. It's pretty bad. Gameplay's good, but
compartmentalize how you desensitize.
Right, bad.
You can't prepare for El Sueño.
El Sueño.
He's got a religious streak that rates pretty close to delusional. He's taken vows of poverty, chastity. If he's not in it for the chocha or the money, he's in it for the power. This joint task force is CIA, DEA, and JSOC. I'm your resident spook for this ride. Welcome to Operation Kingslayer.
Our briefing said there'd be a contingent of locals.
The Qatar is 26. They're a group of rebels who've been giving Unidad and Santa Blanca some resistance. We'll meet their leader, Pak Atari, soon as we touch down. Bolivians have a long history of hating us Yankees, but this time, let's hope the enemy of my enemy will be my friend. But don't turn your back on him. I'm not going to.
Billabongos. Billabongos.
So I remember this dude from the beta and I still don't fucking trust him. Look at that. Look at that fucking setup shot right there. Don't trust this motherfucker.
Four soldiers. This is the help you promised? That Sandoval promised? A single Yankee died, so you send a handful of soldiers. Hundreds of Bolivians have died from Santa Blanca's bullets. Where will my hundreds of soldiers come from?
As Americans, we aren't here, remember? These soldiers are the best covert ops team our country has to offer. With their help, you won't need hundreds of soldiers.
Are you familiar with the word Huber, Senora Bowman?
Meet Pak Atari, leader of the resistance group Qataris 26. We will be working with the rebels to destabilize Santa Blanca's organization. They've been fighting Santa Blanca and corrupt Bolivian officials for nearly 6 years now. We'll need to coordinate targets.
There's no time for this. We have information on Amaru's whereabouts.
Amaru? You found him? Amaru's one of the founders of the Qataris 26.
More than that, our group is founded on his ideas. Without his theories of an agrarian proletariat, there would be no organized resistance against Santa Blanca and the corruption in our government. Amaru must be saved. If you were to assist my people, it would do much to earn my confidence.
Where is he?
We do not know exactly. We know he's in this
Got
province.
Got to give people.
Lieutenant who knows where he is.
I'll put a call into the activity, see if they can dig more intel out of the airwaves. Start looking for that lieutenant and keep me informed of everything via sat phone. Good hunting.
Saving Amaru is important to our cause, Yankee. Make sure you don't kill the Santa Blanca lieutenant before you get the chance to ask him questions.
Who the fuck's he calling a Yankee?
a fucking Yankee. I'm English, you cunt!
That was literally how they spent the night. They just stood here all night as the sun went on by. I think my camo's alright. I think I made the right choice for the camo.
Time to earn your pay, people. Put on your game faces.
Got to get people. However, I need to sort out my paints. I think I just go tan every time. Or is it khaki? Bloody khaki. Wait, where the fuck is it? Is there no khaki? There it is. Even look like that she's khaki though, what the hell? It's random. Oh my god, of course they have a gold camo in this. What is the fucking affinity with gold camos? Like, seriously. Jesus Christ. People love gold guns, Call of Duty!
Working with Pakatari and these rebels, their kind of ideology always ends up with more bodies in the ground.
Yeah, we're good.
What's your feeling?
Alright, I didn't want to say this straight up, but I basically played all of this before, in the beta. It's literally the exact same. First objective, track down from the beta. Lieutenants who can find the Maru. So, that being said, we're just going to go do this first mission, and then we're going to smash the entire area, because I'm... Oh, what the fuck? I am going to try and shoot for that 100% hole. Interesting. Media Luna. I wonder what's up there where there's no thingy. Oh, wait, there's another thing over there as well. That's like places with no faces on them. No faces. Yeah, honestly, I'd go do like other random side missions straight away, but might as well just go get a fucking tune-up mission in, I guess. Go fucking remember how bad the arcade driving mechanics of this game are. Fuck that fence. Disrespect to my family. Good job. I'm a fucking beast mode of a job. Oh, shit, better say that. Beast mode of a dragon. Hello, Sara Rularo. This is my jam right now. In fact, I'm gonna pull over here. I don't think there's any intel here, though, actually. Oh no, there is some intel here. Keep pressing Y to get our cards. Goddamn GTA. What's that, amigo? What is this? It's fucking legend. Oh shit, I thought it was Intel. Hey! What the fuck happened to my car? Why is it all battered?
Hang on, I'll drive.
Got smashed windscreen already. Wait, was that from that rock? Holy shit. Not realistic damage in like Forza or something. I don't even know what side of the road they drive on. Rosino. Ah, they drive on the other side of the road.
Dead on the right side of the road.
I still can't remember what, I think it's A maybe for handbrake. I can't remember right now. Oh shit. This is basically me taking down El Chapo. There's the one thing that still fucking triggered me about this game was that you couldn't swap like camera shoulders, if that makes any sense.
Just spotted one with submachine guns. I got a third target.
Pretty sure that's meant to be like a FOF.
Got eyes on the target. Let's move.
Assassino!
Don't want to spook the target. Switch to suppressors.
Oh, believe you me, we're going to be using suppressors the whole goddamn time.
Hostile down.
Can't remember if my, I literally can't remember if I adjusted my sensitivity when I played the beta. I can't remember right now. I don't think I did, but I may have. And if I did, then... I don't really want all these tutorials right now, but I guess it'd be good just to remember. At least to some extent. But like, the controls are super simplistic, so it's like... Whose bull is this? Dude, there's a pile of dead bodies in there. I thought I told you all motherfuckers to clean your room! Shit, what did it just... Oh, it locked onto like, supplies, never mind.
Moving to position.
Moving to position.
Ready. Call the shot.
Target down. Let the rebels know where to find these supplies.
El Rebilo, as I like to call them. Not the rebels. The El Rebilo. Damn. These fucking savages.
La, 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 la.
I got a narco over here, by the watchtower.
Yeah. Don't worry about these fucking narcos. These narcos. If I remember correctly, I think there was actually only three over here, but... It's better to be safe than sorry. Except we're just gonna kill this dude first off. Give it and take the shot, bitches!
Say the word. He's down.
Fucking bitches! Oh shit, now. Oh fuck, I got my first skill point. You know what? I'll deal with it after this. From what I remember though, like, the way you do your skill points is a fucking. Is a proper saga. Because I want to make sure that I put the skill points into the right categories early on. Because if I don't, it will fuck me up because of the hard extreme difficulty.
Silencio, marche. Shut the fuck up. Tell me what you know! Where is she?
Here's the deal. You answer my questions, or I put a bullet in your gut and leave you.
Where is she?
Shit. No enciendes.
Where's the judge?
What do you want?
Amaru. Where can I find him?
Oh yes, oh yes. Yo, what up, judge? Yes, on Nintendo Switch.
Sure thing. He's at Atoya Farm. Go on. Then you can see what we do to people who fuck with us. People like you.
Shoot this motherfucker. That wasn't right. You might have cap him one time. The fuck? I hate how they don't do that. You should be allowed to shoot him in the head after they're dead.
Shit, if they've been working on him for a while, there's a good chance he's already
shoot
dead.
This motherfucker.
Maybe, maybe not. Amaru's a major player in the rebel movement. The cartel will keep him alive as long as they can to find out what he knows.
We can't afford to
kill all of these bastards.
Too much riding on this. Let's move. That's a kill.
That's a kill.
So yeah, basically I need to work out how I want to put these skill points together. The drone is super important. Cartel isn't gonna and to track down and rescue Amaru. Yeah, there's a lot of super important shite. Just remember, I only get one sync shot, lol.
Ready, call the shot.
Not ready yet, hold on, don't be stupid. You didn't kill him. Yeah, I know, that's what I'm saying. You should be able to kill the dude instead of, you know. It's like Hitman. Well, kind of. Or like Metal Gear Solid. You can either, like, knock them out when you've got them in, like, grabbed, or you can kill them. You know what I mean? You should be able to kill them. Why would I knock out this lieutenant dude and just keep him alive? You know what I'm saying? It doesn't make sense. The whole deal with it. From what I remember, drone is ridiculously important. But what's more important than anything is sync shot. Having a sync shot for my fucking friendly so I can have them take out motherfuckers more than one at the same time is way more important to begin with. Plus, I'm going to try and, like, yeah, we're going to try and hench mode it up anyway.
Olé, Batorue. Make it can't believe you.
Roger. Let me get in position.
You get in position.
Ready to engage.
Get out, you fucking... No, get out. What are you doing, dickhead?
Engaging hostiles.
It's totally a different... There's totally another enemy around there somewhere that I didn't notice. I can hear him singing.
The old-fashioned way.
Oh, you bastard.
Tango down.
Woodley won. Kappa. Decision was as bad as the first one, so hard for me to complain about. I thought Woodley won the first fight, and then Wonderboy won the second fight, but the second fight I thought was closer to being a draw. Was up for a draw, so people wouldn't watch the fight again. Honestly, I don't know, dude. Like, I don't know. I just wish, like, straight up at this point, I'm still, like, a massive fan of Wonderboy, but Woodley is such a bitch, dude. Having him as the welterweight champion is such a massive downside right now. Get GSP to fight him or something. Just let GSP just wrestle him and lie on him for fucking 25 minutes. Honestly, I lost respect for Wonderboy as well. Wonderboy just needs to go back to his old days, man, like. He's so obsessed with the title right now, and I don't know why. Like, he could be putting on so many more entertaining fights, but he's basically locked in this gridlock. I feel like at this point, there's no way that fucking Wonderboy is gonna beat Woodley. It's just, I don't see it happening. Knowing the logic of the UFC, though, they might be like, alright, fuck it, let's do the fight again. Like, I mean, it's not unheard of to just do the trilogy again. It's just 100% no. Woodley lost that fight 100%. They were protecting him. He lost the first, the second, and the fourth. Why do these rebels even bother? Triggered, man. Triggered. The card was pretty... I mean, this weekend's card looks better at this stage, actually, to be honest. But basically, the card's just kind of, like, pale at this stage.
I'll drive.
The Mark Hunt fight was like, Jesus Christ. Lando Venata lost, I was like fucking triggered. Wonderboy won't beat Maya. Woodley could knock out Maya, Wonderboy can't. That's not true. I don't agree with that at all. I think Maya wins probably both situations if he's just gonna fucking jujitsu the fuck out of him. I think if anything, Wonder Boy has a better chance of keeping range and distance on Maya. So, yeah, I think, honestly, what's next for Wonder Boy is him versus Robbie Lawler. You'll probably see that. Robbie Lawler. And then, I guess, like, considering Maya's locked in with Jorge Masvidal, which should be a ridiculous fight. Woodley said that he's doing a bum move. It's like, yeah, I'm taking time off. I'm going to go film a movie. It's like, oh, my God. Because that dude was, like, an actor. He wasn't, like, fucking Straight Outta Compton and shit. Triggered, man. So Woodley's doing a bitch move, so he's basically tying up the belt and thinks that he's justified in tying up the belt because he's had so many decisive victories so far in terms of defending his belt. Yeah, his legacy is fucking tarnished. He will forever be remembered as the dude who won the belt and then basically had two really close decisions, arguably lost in the judges' eyes. And I went to go film fucking Fast and Furious 10 or something. I don't even know if it's Fast and Furious 10, but I know he's going to go film a movie. He said he's leaving for like, he's not fighting for like.
Bolivians take over. But this country's all changed. It used to be FARC taking Bolivian cocaine to Mexico.
Woodley has no way of appealing.
Moves out, some other guy moves in.
Lord, he's dead.
Santa Blanca moves out.
Dude, have you not seen it when, I think Woodley, I think Lawler takes people's souls, not Woodley taking Lawler's soul. Google the video of Robbie Lawler talking about taking somebody's soul. It is the creepiest thing ever, and it makes you realize how much of a psycho Lawler probably is. It's like, nah, I wouldn't fight him. Because if I fought him, I'd take his soul. And it is cold death stare. And that's it. Fucking interview over. Holy shit. Oh shit. Now watch me hit this drive. Oh shit, no matter what. Future fight for the belt. Masvidal, Maya tied up, Cerrone and Law lost, Wonderboy lost. Who's worthy? Well, that's what I'm saying then. Like, it depends. Like, it depends how long Woodley's going to be gone for. Like, yeah, I'm taking a break. Going to go film a movie. It should be GSP probably after the Bisping fight. But the question is, could you make GSP and Woodley? Because what you got to think is that GSP was probably the best welterweight of all time in the UFC, right? Regardless of how he went out, because I still don't see why everybody's getting so hyped, because he went out in a real bad fashion. He just did. It was not a good, like, his last, he retired on a win, yeah, as the champion, but go look at his record, dude. He finished on a 10-win streak or something retarded. All 10 of them were decisions. He was just decisioning the fuck out of everybody because he didn't retire because he couldn't do it. He retired because it was too easy for him to take somebody down and just lie on them for fucking 25 minutes. That was seriously all of his fights. He didn't become a drawer anymore. It was fucked up. Wait, is Battlefield 3 coming on backwards compatibility? Are you kidding me? Oh boy. Yes, I did say that. He's a little close to civilians. Fucking course I do. The hype is real. EA making plays right now because they've got connections with Xbox. Hell yeah, if it's coming to back compat. I'm all down with the back compat. It's been backwards compatible for a while. Shut the fuck up. No, it's not. Get out of here. I would have heard about it. My soldiers are literally just right in the field next to this dude, and he doesn't even notice them. It's
the problem with the AI in this game at times.
Yeah, but honestly, other than GSP for the Woodley, I don't know, dude. I don't know. There's probably only one other person, and it would probably have to be Wonderboy again. But the fact is, it's a draw and then a loss. In all ways, Wonderboy should have won that fight, in my opinion. Even though I think the first fight was close. So it's tricky, man. It's tricky. I heard people saying that they were scoring the first round. Scoring the first round, like, no, the first and third round, like 10-10.
Copy. Target marked. Got it.
Oh, no, dude. Shit, somebody noticed. Oh, I know it didn't. Came out on January 10th. Really? Wait, it came out with Battlefield 3? I mean, Battlefield 2? Really? Dude, what the hell? I did not realize that. At all.
Good to go.
Yes, I did not realize that.
Got the target. Tango is fucking down.
This is ridiculous. They're all just like walking out into the middle of the field and the fucking squad's just there chilling. You gave a 10-8 round and a round 5 based on the fact that nothing happened in the 4.5 rounds leading up to it. Dana White disagrees. Round 5 was 10-8, but not 5-8. Definitely. I don't know, though. It's really, if you consider, like, the knockdown. I'd consider the takedown more valuable than the knockdown, if I'm being honest. But I can't remember what round the takedown happened in. I think it was round 3, right? I don't know, though. The knockdown wasn't, like... I feel as though if Woodley would have capitalized upon the knockdown, way better. Then I'd be like, yeah.
Bad guys are marked, waiting on you, boss.
I can't help but feel that it was just kind of...
Say the word.
Overall, the fight sucked.
Tango down.
Personally, I think the fight was bad. However... Yeah, I guess 10-8 would be there. I guess 10-8 would be there. But, like, the thing is, right? New rule sets and everything are so weird because, like I said, a lot of people were scoring some of the rounds 10-10. And I was like, what? 10-10? Really? I need this dude to wait there, because, yeah. I don't know. Like, yeah, so here's my point I'm trying to make, right? You could technically start calling 10-8 rounds because of, like, them not engaging in a manner of speaking. But then it's like, right, well, who do you give the 10-8 round to? That's why a lot of people were saying, oh, it'd just be like, it's a travesty to call it 10-9 because a lot of the rounds are so close. You know what I'm saying?
That's a kill.
I just think that honestly, Woodley was just... Woodley just kind of bitched out, man. I don't know. Like, I just feel like... They were both scared of each other and getting knocked out, and it's kind of a sense of mutual respect. And I'm not saying I'm not saying they should like just start brawling and shit, because that's not smart. But yeah, I don't know, man. I don't know. Is there like another enemy around here somewhere? Why are we all like? I think I just cleaned it out. That's how you do fucking covert shit. lot of lights. He didn't want to end it so late into round 5 with Wonderboy looking like he had the win. Oh, I missed the beginning part. Oh, it beat John. Yeah. Where are you taking me? I guess maybe, yeah. I guess. It's hard to say, though. Because it wasn't really like a legit knockdown. He was turtled up and covering up. And it was like, oh, shit, if this keeps on going on. But, yeah, I guess that was probably like a contributing factor that beat John was like. So late into the round. To stop it now, I feel like it'd be a bit of a travesty. I just don't understand how Woodley can be played. Dude, Woodley has been this fighter basically his entire career. And this is why I can't understand anybody that like really likes him, like as a fighter. Not as like a personality. It's nothing about his personality. It's just a being here fighter. It doesn't make sense to me. He's been this entire fighter. Yes, he has this like explosive knockout power and stuff like that, but he never gets into like these legit fights. He's always super, he's a counter striker, he's super premeditated and buys his time, and when an opportunity arises he strikes, and then sometimes he capitalizes upon it. But in this Wonderboy case, it's basically shown that he doesn't always capitalize upon it, and it's been like this a lot of his fucking career. He's been fighting since Strikeforce, dude, and it's the same shit. I don't know, man. It is what it is, really.
This will go nice with my boots.
Come back for that sniper later. A lot of people will try this game and jump out of the heli. Well, the heli's bug when I was playing the beta. It bugged a lot. I think it bugged like 3 or 4 separate times, and I'm rarely ever in them. In fact, no, I was in them quite a lot. You need to get parachute as well. It's one of the big fucking things that will save you from dying from a bug.
But their methods were not.
Were their names Yuri and Polito?
Si. Yuri Polito.
Yuri Polito.
The fucks that tortured Ricky Sandoval was when you questioned him. I want them back.
We only saw run-of-the-mill Sicarios when we freed Amaru.
But I haven't seen Yuri and Polito in at least 3 days, maybe 4. I don't know where they are now.
We need
Oh my god, they've interrogated him so much he has no concept of days. Until we find something.
Somebody's gotta know.
The summer's up, the summer's down, the summer's up. I don't remember anymore.
Interrogate hostile lieutenants, talk to civvies, whatever it takes.
We'll turn over every rock.
Fuck the female. Wait, what the fuck? Why do I need to cheat? No, she's like the CIA agent, you know?
The CIA agent.
Heads up. Bowman's file on Yuri and Polito's coming through.
They always have like they always gotta cast him. It's like fucking Zero Dark 30, you know? How like a woman. Well, I mean, no, well, that's like a real life story, but you know, I guess that's kind of like what I feel personally, like, sprouted a lot of, you know, deshi in video games in particular. Same shit happened in Rainbow Six, kind of, when they had that, whatever her face is called. I can't remember which card, whatever, you know. You know what I mean, mate? You know what I fucking mean, geezer? Right. I'm wondering right now what's important, and I'm still thinking sync shot is the most important thing. I think I need to do sync shot drone, and then I'm gonna get like a load of points now anyway, so it doesn't really matter. So sync shot is like the thing that is mostly beneficial right now. Oh shit, I can't get it because I don't have 2. Never mind, bollocks. Should I get? Oh, I can't get parachute because I don't have enough thing. Right, let's do drone range.
Run down on like Yuri and El Polito. They're a
small map.
Can tell them
it. What do you mean,
operation?
Small map? Yeah, this is a tiny map. Not like this whole fucking map around here. You see how long it took me? I flew from there. Where did I fly from? Bro, I don't even know where I flew from. I flew from somewhere over there across a mountain to there. That was just like that distance. This is this entire area. And then this is it. And each of these areas are like different biomes. It's like jungles and snowy mountains. It's like fucking 10% is playable. Dude, I can fly into these other areas. I can go into any of these areas right now and start doing these missions. You don't have to do it, progress it in order. You can do whatever you want. It's just that I'm in this area currently. That's all it is. Played this in the beta though, so like, remember, I already know all of this, and I know like the first two missions basically.
El Muro, the Wall, personal bodyguard and childhood friend to El Sueño. El Muro's little brother is La Plaga. Nasty piece.
99% is woods. It's not even 99% is woods. It's like, look at this, man. Like, come on. Like, there's individual towns around here. And then it's basically approaching these locations. You know what? Maybe like 10%. I don't know. I understand what you're saying now. Never mind. But like, there's densely populated like urban areas and whatnot, or like built-up areas, I guess you could say. But it's the same shit that happens in Metal Gear Solid. Huge map for the most part. But you're only traveling to like these outposts and everything. This game is so similar to Metal Gear Solid, it's unbelievable. See, I don't get what you mean by you say it has zero playability though, because it's a case of realism. That's all it is. It's a case of realism. You're not just going to have like all of the objective locations right next to each other. You have them spread apart because in logical reasoning, if you get into a firefight in said location, there's a location right next to it, then why aren't these people coming? That's why you have it like all separated. How are you honestly trying to hate on realism right now?
There's gotta be some intel we can dig up around here.
That doesn't make any sense. Get out of the helicopter, what the fuck? Oh shit, this dude's running! Where you going, motherfucker? What do you know?
Hi, how's it going?
Oh shit. Jesus Christ, Judge, what the fuck? Damn, some Judge W. Bush comment right now. You know how offensive that word is? Holy shit. You get stabbed in some places. You get stabbed in some places in the UK for saying that word to the wrong people.
Nomad, I've got Pacatari on the line. Sounds like he needs our help.
Pacatari.
Put him through.
Hola, compadre. I have a problem in Itaqua, and Bowman says you may be able to help. My people need help. There have been many losses to the cartel, and the horrors inflicted by Yuri Polito have broken their spirit. The fires of revolution have almost gone out.
Spare me the rhetoric, Atari. Just tell me what you need.
There is a cartel.
Dude, that word is offensive no matter where you are, dude. Judge Bush apologized when he said that. Because he was thinking it was like an abbreviation to like the Brits or,
taking orders from Pac-Atari,
you know, whatever. I don't know.
Atari needs this convoy. We are going to give it to him.
She's offensive as fuck. Oh, it ain't offensive in the US. Don't fucking matter, son. It's just offensive anyway. Oh my god, it's hilarious. They say all kinds of offensive shit in the UK, but it doesn't mean it's right. It's still offensive. Look, right, if George W. Bush apologized, then you gotta apologize, George. Gotta apologize. Official apology.
Everybody hold up, we got hostiles in the area. I got a Sicario over here.
Yeah. We know. dude up in that tower as well. Still wish that you could swap camera angles in this game, man. It's so triggering. I just want to be able to look over my right shoulder. That's all.
I got one of those cartel medals here. Some Sicario is gonna miss this.
What the fuck?
Drag it down.
That was random.
Okay, we're still alright.
Like, stood up and instantly noticed me.
This is a common
take the skill points. Like love the skill points. True the skill points. What the fuck am I doing with these doors? George Bush is the president. I don't know about that one.
I got eyes on a sniper.
Target set, ready to assault.
What if my boys can take this dude down?
I've got the target.
Oh, they can.
Got him, he's down.
Kill him.
Deploying drone.
For no reason other than just killing him.
Target marked. Keep an eye on your background. I see a second target.
Oh shit, there's more than one. Interesting. In fact, you know what I'm going to do right now, though, anyway? I'm going to get my second... I got two skill points, right? Oh, I didn't know you only got one. I spent it, didn't I? This is some bullshit, man! God damn, I keep pressing the wrong buttons. Fucking triggered.
Say the word, boss.
You got it, T. Take him down.
Kill confirmed.
Ah, the choice of having a squad. The drone should have a gun on it. It would make it too easy. But I think, like, I can't remember. I've never got that far up the progression tree. You weren't able to do it. But I believe, like, the thingy that you can get at the end is an explosive. So like you fly in the drone and it like fucking it's like a brick of C4, and then you got like an EMP on it. I don't really know what armor does because like the drone never really gets shot, and then like you can get medic as well, so like you can revive teammates with the drone. Other than that, stealth's a big thing as well. Drone is so important in this game. I sometimes question the progress tree or like the skill tree in this game. It's slightly strange how it all comes together. It's slightly strange because a lot of the things that, well, basically a lot of the things that you do could like it could just be done in like a different manner. It almost feels like a bit of a mismatch in a manner of speaking. Like what easily could have been like unlocked or like bought with some kind of currency is like in a skill tree, and it's like not really a skill, it's like such emphasis upon the drone. If you know what I'm saying? Like the drone's like really important, and then they have like within the skill points tree as well, it's like you get all these other random things. I don't know. It's slightly strange.
GPS says the place is named Yopil. I don't see any signs of fighting. It's just a ghost town.
I suppose ghost either the town. Cartel or the dogs chased everybody off.
Yes, that's it.
They're all dead. Ghost town.
That's the whole thing about this game, is there's a lot of mundane shit of like just going and randomly picking up things, but I'm OCD enough to do that shit. Oh, I can't take that down yet. I need a fucking mine or something. How you flying the heli for you didn't go to pilot school? Dude, the flying mechanics in this game are skittish! We have been to there before. We need to start up there or something. Driving mechanics are super skittish. I mean, like, they feel really arcadey. The flying mechanics are really arcadey as well. It seems slightly improved since the beta.